Today we're going to be talking about how to do a Laplace transform when we have access to a table of Laplace transforms. There are two ways that you'll perform a Laplace transform. The first is using the definition of a Laplace transform, which is where you take the integral from 0 to infinity of your function multiplied by e to the negative st. That's using the definition. Oftentimes, though, you'll have access to a table of Laplace transforms, and the table will show you common functions and their corresponding Laplace transforms. So for example, in this particular problem, we've been given this function g of t, and I've identified three functions in our Laplace transform table that are formulas that will help us out here. Keep in mind that if we're taking the Laplace transform of g of t, we can take the Laplace transform of each of these three terms separately and then put them together. So in this case, we have e to the 3t, and we're going to be using the Laplace transform equation here for a function e to the at, where a is a constant. In our case, a is equal to 3. Then we have a second term in our original function, cosine of 6t. And if we look at our Laplace transform table, and any Laplace transform table should have this. So if you're using a table, you should see a Laplace transform equation or formula for cosine of at, where a is a constant. In our case, it's equal to 6. Then we've got our last term here in our original function, e to the 3t cosine of 6t. And any Laplace transform table should also have this e to the at cosine of bt, where a and b are constants. So if you're using a table, this becomes really easy. If you want to learn how to use the definition, please look at my video about how to perform Laplace transforms with the definition of a Laplace transform. But in this case, it's really just plugging in our constants a and b. So the Laplace transform here of g of t, we're going to call it capital F of S, which is our notation for Laplace transform. Remember that when we're doing this transformation, we're moving from an equation or a function that's defined in terms of t, or whatever our variable is, to a different equation that's in terms of S. So to perform the Laplace transform here, we're going to look at our first term, e to the 3t. We can see that a is equal to 3. So our Laplace transform, according to the formula, is going to be 1 over s minus 3. Keep in mind that the s is always going to stay. You're only going to be plugging in for a and b. So that's our first term. Then we have this plus here. So we're going to go ahead and add to that. Cosine of 6t. Using our formula here, we can see that a is equal to 6. So our formula is going to give us s over s squared plus 6 squared. So we'll go ahead and put that in there. And then we have a minus sign, so we'll go ahead and subtract. We can see here from our third term, e to the 3t cosine of 6t, and our formula, that a is going to be equal to 3, and b is going to be equal to 6 in our original function. So if we plug that into our formula, we'll have s minus 3 divided by the quantity s minus 3 squared plus 6 squared. And that's it. We just plug in our constants, and now all we need to do is simplify. You don't have to, and you probably shouldn't, combine these fractions into one, so we'll go ahead and leave them separately. We'll say 1 over s minus 3 plus s over s squared plus 36 minus s minus 3 divided by the quantity s minus 3 squared plus 36. So we'll just multiply those out. The 6 squareds will evaluate that, but other than that, we'll leave the function as it is. So this function here, f of s, is our Laplace transform. It's our final answer. I hope that video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one.